Hello, this is Angela Anderson. Thanks for joining me today. We are going to be painting a really fun project. This is our mermaid collaboration day with my friend Cinnamon Cooney, the art Sherpa. She was, her husband is sick today, so she's going to be on tomorrow. But we're going to go ahead and do our mermaid today. But I've got all the links down in the description for part one, which was my coral reef here. We did this on Tuesday night for the backdrop for our mermaid, and then we're going to add her to it. Today I've got my husband Mark here.
Hey everybody.
He is manning the chat. We're live today, so we will take your questions while I paint, and if you've got anything you want to ask, you can just put that in all caps and he'll try to get that to me. So let's get started here. This is my example. I went ahead and decided to make her a little bit larger. So what I did was took a tracing of my mermaid and then blew it up a little bit bigger. So she's about 25% bigger than this example, so that I really wanted to fill up this entire space with my mermaid. So I just went ahead and did a tracing on my canvas so that I didn't have to draw her twice. But I'm going to show you how I drew her.
Are you going to share that tracing?
Yes, I have the tracing already shared on on my Thankful Art page. I need to share it on Instagram and Pinterest still, but yes.
So do we want to stop the show so you can do that?
No.
No? Okay.
No. I don't think so. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see the tracing marks a little bit better. So when I started her, I decided, on my paper here, I decided how big I wanted to make her. Well, I'm going to have to zoom out so you can see the boundaries there. How big I wanted to make her, and kind of just tried to estimate how large. I kind of do this weird thing where I kind of do the circle, and then I sort of try to figure out where the arms are going to go, and then sort of do this before I even touch the paper. I sort of do kind of an imaginary drawing just to kind of work out the sizing of my drawing, and then I kind of just mark the top and bottom so that I sort of know where to shoot for. So on this girl, I wanted to fit her in this entire space here. So I started at her head, and her head's tilted a little bit. So you kind of do a little round cheek here, and then a kind of an angle for her chin, and then round it up this way. And then the top of her head would be up over here. Okay. And we'll fill her in, and I'll do her features here in a second. But then your neck is going to be here. On my girl here, I got her neck farther over than her shoulder. This shoulder really should be cut off right about here. She's a little bit broad-shouldered on that side. But I actually left it, and when I did my tracing, I just moved her head over. So her head doesn't exactly match the tracing. It happens, you know. I don't do figure drawing very often, so this was kind of a good challenge for me. I enjoyed it, but I definitely noticed that after I painted her. Her head and her neck was a little bit off. So, okay, so you come down a little bit for her neck, and then you kind of angle down slightly to the shoulder, and then come sort of straight across. There's kind of a circle right here and here where the cap of her shoulder is, so make sure you round that off. And then I did very, very simple arms. If you did my angel painting, it's very simple similar pose to my angel. The arms are just kind of sort of floating out to her sides. So make the forearms narrow here. There's a slight bend where the elbow is, and this part and this part, the forearm and the upper arm, are about the same length. So just make sure you don't have, you know, your hand sitting up here real short. Narrow it a little bit for the wrist, and then I'm just doing kind of a curve for the fingers and sort of the thumb coming down like that. It's going to look weird, but I didn't want to go into too much detail. So,
now, what kind of pencil are you using right now?
This is an aquarellable, water-soluble General Scryball pencil. It's a white, basically it's like a watercolor pencil. So you could use chalk for this, but because this was a little bit more detailed, I figured the pencil would work a little bit better. It can be kind of difficult to draw on the canvas, so you really have to kind of scrub it. I did the tracing with my white graphite paper, though, so these original lines are from the graphite. So you're going to do two kind of semicircles for her breast that sort of come up from underneath the underarm and down. You don't want her breasts up high up here, so they kind of come from the underarm and curve around, and then curve her waist in. She, again, has not had any children, obviously. Although I did give her some hips this time. I figured she kind of, you know, like a dolphin, you got to have a little bit of booty to get the, you know, water propulsion in the water. You got she got to have a little bit of muscle there to. So I kind of rounded out her derriere on that side and her hip on this side. And then I just did a long sweeping curve to bring her tail up. Her tail is probably too long, but I wanted to fill up this area, so she's got a super long tail. And don't make any comments on that. I know you're thinking.
I'm keeping my mic muted.
I'm narrowing her. She doesn't, these aren't legs, so all the pictures actually that I had for reference of like women in mermaid costumes had this weird bend in the knee right here. But I'm going to make her nice and fluid and long. So I'm not putting any bends in her because she's not got legs under there. She's a mermaid. Okay, so nice long S curve. A little bit low there, sorry. Then I just kind of did a round, like a semicircle for her waist and a little dot for her belly button. We'll put that in later because we're going to be filling in with some color. And then her tail, I wanted to do it kind of wispy. So again, if you did my angel, it's kind of like that same way we did the wings where they're going to be sort of just stripes of color instead of a solid. I thought it'd be easier, and I kind of like that look, like it's sort of see-through almost. So there. And then there's a couple of little ones that sort of come off the edge. You can leave these out if you don't like them, but I kind of thought she might have some little extra fins on the sides here. Like that. All right. So that's our basic mermaid. That's her hair. I took a part like right about here and curved it up and over from there on both sides. Then she's going to have some bangs coming down over her forehead a little bit. We'll fill in her face all the way up to the top so that when we put those bangs in, there'll be some color underneath. And then her hair is just going to sort of float around the sides and do these nice long S-curve shapes like it's caught in the current, and these on this side are not as far out, so like it's maybe pushing her hair this way a little bit. And don't forget to have some behind up under her arms peeking through.
So this is like a 90s mermaid, like big hair?
Big hair, yes, absolutely. Okay. Hey, it's wishful thinking. She actually, I didn't really intend this, but she looks a little bit like Cinnamon with the purple hair. So this is a Cinnamon mermaid. Maybe she made hers brunette and will match. I don't know. That was unintentional. I was going for the color choices, but I think it works. So, all right. So our color palette today is pretty simple. I did the same color palette that I used for my coral reef, only we're not going to really need the oranges and red today, but it's this is the cadmium yellow light, and I used it a little bit in some of the shimmery detail on her, on the front of her. Phthalo green, not sure we're going to need that today, but we'll see. Teal, this is a mixture of phthalo green and phthalo blue plus white. It's a pre-mixed color, but you can mix it yourself. Phthalo blue, ultramarine blue, purple, dioxazine purple, quinacridone magenta, burnt sienna. This will be our undertone for our skin tone, along with the phthalo blue. And then this is our main skin tone, which is unbleached titanium. And if you don't have that color, you can mix titanium white with a little bit of yellow oxide. to get this off-white color. This is zinc white, and I thought we might use a little bit of that in the tail. And carbon black for the eye details. And that's about it. So let's get started. Are we good with our comments? No comments or questions or anything yet?
We just had somebody had asked about the pencil again.
Oh, so. Okay.
But we got that covered.
Yep. All right, so I'm going to grab this unbleached titanium, and to start out, I'm just going to fill in her face with this, her face and her arms and everything. And I've used my number 4 round. You can use whatever brush you're comfortable with that will give you some control. This one's acting up on me today. I might have to switch to a firmer brush. Oops, thank you. Are you going to keep me on camera today?
I'm going to try. I keep meaning to get a monitor so I can watch it over here.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, time
goes
by.
Yeah, that must be hard to see it over there.
Got a comment. People loving your sparkly nail polish.
That's fun. Yeah.
And I didn't help this time.
No, nope, you didn't have to help this time.
You're
getting better.
I'm getting better.
I find that the sparkly ones are not as bad for... I'm grabbed a little bit of burnt sienna here, and I'm just going to add it under her chin here, just to her neck, mostly on this one side. This will be our shadow side. This will be our highlight side over here. So I'm just going to add it right up underneath her chin there. And then it'll be on the back side of her arms here. So I'm just going to use up what's on my brush here to kind of fill in her arm, underneath her breasts, and between them we'll have some of that color. Okay, so it's starting to go away. I'm going to go ahead and grab some more of this. We'll keep on going. So that just helps me from having to clean out my brush. I just use it where else I know I'm going to need it later. And then go back to my main color here. And while that's wet, I'm just going to kind of lightly tap over it a little bit. I'm not pressing down hard at all. It's very, very minimal pressure. And it'll kind of just blend and soften that edge, the transition between the two colors a little bit. We may end up adding a little bit more detail to it later. But quiet.
Well, just going to mention to those who are coming in just now, you're not extremely late, that you're just adding on to the painting you did on Tuesday. So there is a video out there that shows the ocean and the coral reef and all that stuff.
Right. And if you want to do it the way I did over here and just do the background with blues to green and not have the coral reef, all I did was start out with teal up at the top, do the teal across, and then added phthalo blue plus a little bit of white to that and mixed it while it was still wet up here, blended it out. And it's okay if you get these streaks because it actually kind of looks like there's layers to the water, things going on. I just kept my strokes horizontal back and forth. You could add a little glazing medium to help its flow a little bit better. Then as I went down to the bottom, I added more phthalo blue, less white. And then as I got down to about right here, I started adding ultramarine blue. And at the very bottom, I added some purple. So it's just teal, phthalo blue, ultramarine, purple. And that's how I did this background this way. And then at the very top here, I did a few little water lines in the lightest area with some white and the teal color. So I didn't mean to mention that. I'm glad you said that. But I do that in the very beginning of this video. So if you want to watch that process, you can watch the coral reef part one, and we do the background just the same way, except for I added some coral under here with the purple, just kind of in the distance, and some fish and things. But this was actually pretty easy. I would say that this is definitely a beginner. It looks kind of difficult, but most of this is sponged on. So, and you can leave the fish and the more difficult things off if you don't want to do them. But this is very, very simple background. Honestly, it looks more complicated than it is. So I would definitely say, I would totally do this with kids. So anytime I can say that, I would say it was definitely a beginner, first time painting for sure. Totally achievable. Yeah, if you are first to our channel or new to our channel, I do. Mark helps, but he doesn't paint. Maybe someday we'll get him to paint.
Maybe on the 100,000 show.
There you go. That would be fun, actually. Something to go for. I teach, I've been painting for about 30 years now, almost, and do gallery shows, been, doing art stuff, related stuff for years and years and years, and just started teaching in the last, I've taught off and on all the way through, but started teaching kids about 10 years ago, I guess, and just absolutely fell in love with it, and it sort of took over. I just decided that I really enjoyed teaching, and here I'm adding some of that burnt sienna between her breasts here to give her a little cleavage and underneath. I decided to do a video on some of the projects that I was doing with my kids' class here locally, and that's how I got into doing the YouTube stuff, and really didn't intend for it to become a thing. I just was sort of sharing what I was doing in my local classes, and it's turned into a full-time job, so it's been a wild few years. That was 2014, I think, so I've been doing the videos since then. I took a whole year off where I didn't do any videos, and so but this last year we've started doing it full-time. And now we're doing two per week. So, and we're going to continue that schedule doing these live shows. We really enjoyed the live, because I'm used to painting live with folks. So it's more natural for me not to have to record and edit. I just like to have the interaction with folks. I don't like sitting in my studio talking to myself. I'm going to add the lighter color now and just blend it up over. Put your thick paint down. I know folks are saying that that the blending is difficult for them, or they have trouble with it. I know it there's definitely a knack to it, but once you put your dark color down where you want it the brightest, or your bright color where you want it the brightest, then you can either wipe off your brush, or if your brush starts to run out of paint, then you just go back over that transition area very lightly and just see how that blends out. I'm just barely touching it, and it blends out that edge, so it's not such a hard edge. I'm probably gonna go back in there. I added some of the dark to the underside of her arm here too, so we'll grab a little bit of the color here. We'll do her hands. Keep them very simple. You don't have to put a whole lot of detail in there for you can kind of tell what it is. She's not, super detailed. I'm trying to keep it simple. There we go. So her thumbs are pointing down, kind of curving in a little bit, over here. So you can kind of get that idea that it's sort of like that. Right here. You might make her fingers just a little bit longer. There we go. All right, so that's pretty much what we're gonna do. We'll probably add a little bit more because she's a little bit splotchy in some places. If you're not using heavy body acrylics, you might need two or three coats on her. If you're using like craft acrylics or something like that, they might not cover as well. These are opaque colors. This unbleached titanium is opaque, which means it covers pretty well. So shouldn't have too much trouble with it. Let's go ahead and fill in her body. I'm going to switch it over to an angle brush. She's actually going to go pretty fast today. Honestly, this didn't take me very long. Mark's laughing because I always say that.
No, I just cleared my throat, had something stuck in my throat there. Sorry.
Yeah.
Every time I say my show is going to go fast, it takes three times longer than I say it will.
Somebody did ask if...
Oh, I've got Teal here. Sorry. This is Teal.
If you would be able to give any suggestions about showing how sunlight would be streaming down.
Yes, yes. I asked her to remind me. Okay. Yeah, I think... I was looking at the composition. I'm thinking, I guess we could do a few like coming from over here. I mean, the light source is really kind of behind her up this way. But since her dark side is on this side, it wouldn't really make sense. We'd have to probably have the light coming from this side. So we'll add a few little streaks just coming from, oops, I'm showing things that are not off the camera, sir. Sorry. So the light source is up here behind her, kind of, or right above her head. But we'll go ahead and put the, since her shadows are on this side, we'll go ahead and put the light source coming from this side. So I'll probably do some little streaks of light coming down from here. But you'll probably want to have mixing white or zinc white for that. So, and definitely some glazing medium, which I already had glazing medium on the list of things, but I added the zinc white this morning, so to the materials list, which is down in the description of the video. Use the angle brush. This is nice because it gets up in these little tight spaces here. You can get a lot of detail, and then I just use it like along its edge to get to do these long lines down her. And we're going to add little dots to her, what is this, body, tail. So you don't have to have the edges perfectly clean, because you can kind of dot the edges, make it a little bit irregular, uneven, make it look like scales or something like that. So don't worry too much if you go outside the lines. You can sort of fix that later. This is a long time coming because I was asked to do a mermaid two summers ago, I think, when I first started doing paintings again full time. So it's taken a while to get this going, but I'd planned on doing her this summer, but then Cinnamon said she was doing a mermaid, and we decided to do the collaboration for our Angeluni group that we have on Facebook. So we do these collaborations. Actually, this month we're going to have three. I put four fingers out, sorry. Three collaborations. And this in January. And then next month we're going to have another one on Valentine's Day for, it'll match our Paris collaboration from last year. So, oh, she's so cute. I love it. I don't know why it's taken me so long to do mermaid. She was really fun. Not as hard as I thought she would be either. I'm going to let that dry, and then I'll add a shadow to this one side of her here, but I'll go ahead and switch back over to my number four round, and we'll do her bikini top here, shell, whatever this is. And I kind of did a scalloped edge at the top, so I'm going to add like little highlights. I don't know if it's scales or a shell or what, whatever you want to make it. It kind of turned out to be looking on mine a little bit more like the tail. So I sort of just did it like the scales almost on her breasts to cover her up. Oh, you could do her bare-chested, I guess, if you wanted to. So that's up to you, but I particularly... We got kids in our, I'm used to teaching to kids, so.
A little more modest.
Yeah, exactly. She's a little more modest mermaid. Yeah. She's more Disney style.
We do have a scandal, not a scandal going on, but a debate.
Uh-oh.
On the belly button.
Yes. Will she have one or not?
Yeah, will she have one or not?
I don't know. Yeah, how are they?
Well, I guess when you're traceable,
well, they're mammals, probably, right? I mean, I would think she's a mammal, so she probably had an umbilical cord. She's probably born out of her mom's belly, so I would say yes.
Okay, all right. Well, you have one on your traceable, so I guess that already answers the question.
But right.
Not sure. I'm not sure of the logistics, but okay.
Mammals have belly buttons, right? They have to because they had an umbilical cord. They weren't hatched out of
it. You're asking
come from an egg.
Don't ask. Just paint. I have no idea. Come on. It's not my forte.
You're not up on your mythical creatures?
No. Maybe they have two belly buttons.
Maybe they could. You never know.
Maybe it's like a shoulder button or something. I mean, since we're talking mythical here.
Could be coming out of her shoulder. Oh, don't get him started, ladies, folks. All right, I've got purple now. I'm going to go ahead and start putting in her hair. And I added a little bit of white to it just because that purple will actually look like black if you try to put it on top of the blue. Straight doxazine purple is pretty much as close to black as you can get with the color. So we have to add a little bit of white to it just to make it purpley. Well, it'll still be dark, but it won't look like. Go ahead and I feel like I covered her too much of her face there. There we go. So we'll go ahead and start putting in her hair. I've got the number 4 round. Again, actually, I did the hair with the smaller brush.
Are you you're not painting on camera?
Thank you.
It wasn't me that mentioned. Somebody was like, asked about, what happened to her forehead. So just redo that whole section again.
Okay.
Just pretend.
Okay.
Painting.
Just went around her face.
Do.
Up around.
Yeah.
And then we'll start. I'm going to end the hair with the tip of my brush. I'm never going to start at the tip and pull in this way because your thicker line is going to be where you start the line. It'll always be thinner where you end it. So when I'm doing these hair pieces, I'm going to do it almost pretty much solid right up next to her face here. And just be really careful. And behind her shoulder. And then as it comes around the side, we can start being a little bit more wispy and letting the hair sort of trail off. And have some space in between the individual strands. Okay, we'll put some up underneath her arm. Keep it pretty solid under there, and then it's almost like octopus hair. It kind of reminded me a little bit of octopus tentacles, which works for sea creature. I just had a vision of her like hiding and making her hair look like one of these, like she'd just kind of blend into the reef, and look like she didn't want to be seen.
Well, that's how they hide from us.
Exactly.
That's why nobody's ever seen one.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Well. That's why it's so easy for her to hide because her hair looks like the coral. All right. I don't know if I like what I've done here. Okay, I'll do that. All right, then I'm going to grab some white and mix a lighter purple and start laying in some streaks that sort of go over the top. And I'm doing this while it's wet because it'll blend a little bit in what I've already got. So just leave a lot of space in between. Oh, my dog's barking at somebody. There we go. You don't need a whole lot to just make it look like it's kind of catching the light a little bit. And you can kind of give direction to the hair. It's all, the ones right here near her chin are going to come straight down, kind of angled out a little bit. And then the ones off to the side here will come, they're all going to come from up here on top. So, I mean, a little bit of it will come from the side here, but the direction will, so you don't want any hairs kind of coming and flowing this way towards her body from the outside, because that wouldn't make sense. So you want them all attached to her head and flowing out from there, if that makes sense. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so that's that side. Grab some dark and do this side.
Now, how does a mermaid keep her hair from being all frizzy in that much humidity?
I don't know, it might be part kelp or something. She's, you know, she probably uses like those sea urchins as combs and combs it out with the sea urchins, you know, like the little spiny, or one of, you know, gets a spiny fish to come up and help her comb her hair. The puffer fishes or somebody like that. She's got connections. I'm getting off again. I need a zoom in camera so you can switch to. Need one of those robo cams. All right, so it's coming up there, and then we're going to give her bangs, but I'm not going to do that quite yet because I need to put her shadowing in on her face on that side. So we'll just do her hair for now, and then we'll add the. If you're having trouble getting these long sweeping lines, you can add a little bit of water to your paint. Because when you're using the liner brush or this is a number two round, sometimes you'll need a little bit extra water to make it flow. Or you could use glazing medium if you wanted to, just not too much because you don't want it to thin your color. You want it to be opaque. And I'm going to come right up next to her arm here, nice and dark. So it's going to be darkest right in here, right up next to her, because this is not going to get any light right there. How many people are going to actually be painting this? That's what I'd like to know. Who are watching today? I know several have told me that they're definitely going to be doing it. I can't wait to see these. I've already seen a few people did the coral reef and shared that with me in my Thankful Art group, so. You're not answering me, honey. Are you even listening?
Oh, I'm listening.
Okay.
I was waiting for
answers.
Well, yeah, for the video to catch up. Oh. There's a delay.
True.
And then people in chat would start typing away.
Commenting. Okay, so I'm going to start sort of tangling these hairs and crisscrossing them a little bit.
We have one person. Yep, that's it.
I know Colleen is going to do it. She told me she was.
Yep, that's the one person.
Colleen.
Oh, two, three.
Oh, good. Okay.
Four. Or five. Ooh.
Nice. All right. I'm liking this. Let's do some long ones down here. This needs some down this direction. Just want it balanced so that it's not too lopsided. Okay, that's better, I think. I'm going to grab my white. We'll add some of the white highlights. It's mixed with the purple, so it's not quite straight white. I'll do some nice bright streaks right up by her face. And then just a few to highlight a few of the hairs. I'm just going to go in and highlight some really specific hairs so that I want to bring them forward. Just do an extra bright highlight on just a few of them. That'll really give the hair some movement. Okay, and I'm going to add more hair up here in a minute. So let's clean that out. I'll grab mine. Well, I guess I'll stay with my number two, smaller round. I'll go ahead and make up a shadow color for her face. So I'm going to use the unbleached titanium, a little bit of this burnt sienna, and then I'm going to add a little tiny bit of the phthalo blue too. I'm just going to make this kind of a green color. It's actually going to work because the shadow color would cast the blue from the water on her face, so it seems like a weird color to use, but it actually works. So we're going to just shadow this side of her face. It'll look really dark at first, but then we'll kind of add a little bit more of the lighter color to this side and just blend it in. So just be patient. Kind of start with the dark color along the side there. Tap, 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 and then brush it off. And add a little bit of the unbleached titanium and blend that back in towards the center. So you set the dark side on first, kind of thick. I mean, there's not a lot of paint there, but it's thick enough that you can kind of work with it and it's still wet. And then I've used this flesh tone and go back over it. Let's go ahead and do some to her hairline because it'll be shadowed up underneath here. Use that, grab some of the lighter color and tap back over it. If you have too much paint on your brush, just wipe it off. If you feel like it's covering it instead of blending it, and then just kind of use that dry brush to blend over it very lightly. It will create your shadow for you. Let's go ahead and put some of this darker color up under her chin again. Just make sure we got it nice and dark right there. We'll add some dark color under her armpit there and under this arm. I've got very, very little paint on my brush at this point, so I'm just gonna kind of brush over lightly here and add some shadow to her arm. We'll add some of the darker color between her breasts. Give her some cleavage there. And a little bit underneath. Again, we already have a little bit of that color, but I'm just deepening it up. And then I'll grab the lighter color. And clean my brush up because I was getting some of that blue in it. Make sure I have straight unbleached titanium. There we go. We're going to brighten up the top part of her chest there and her shoulders. I'm going to even grab a little tiny bit of white. And we'll add some white to her shoulders. I'll use my finger just to blend it off. A little bit of white on that shoulder. And then white above her chest on both breasts right here and here. I'm gonna soften that color up just a little bit. I feel like it's a little bit, there we go. Make sense? We're just adding subtle highlights. We'll add a little bit of unbleached titanium.
What brush are you using right now?
This is a number 2 round. It's just a small round. You could even use I wouldn't use a liner brush because it probably wouldn't give you enough surface to blend with. But it's probably 1/8 inch, I would say, wide. I'm going to do a second coat on the hand and the arm here and mostly just keep it to the highlight side so that it brightens up the arm just a little bit, but it still has some roundedness. Grab a little bit of that darker color and re-emphasize the underside being a little bit darker while that's wet. Not want to come off there. Let me add a little bit of water. My burnt sienna is a Liquitex color and it drives me crazy because it's very, very thick and it doesn't want to blend very well sometimes. Need to get a golden. I find the golden paints are a little bit more fluid, a little bit easier to blend sometimes. But Liquitex, this is a Liquitex color, the unbleached titanium. They don't have it in golden. They have a color called Titan Buff, but it's not, I don't like it as well. It's not the same. Okay, so just re-emphasizing my shadows. We'll go ahead and do the sides of her, under her breasts here and her sides just a little bit. And then grab a little bit of the lighter color and do her belly because it was a little bit blotchy with the lighter color. And then while I've got this darker color, I'm just going to add, maybe just grab a little bit of the phthalo blue to add just a little bit of the belly button right there. Okay. I think she's pretty good as far as the shadows go. That's all you really need to do. And then, I need to make sure that there's a shadow right up under her armpit here. On that side. There we go. Okay, so now let's put in her, let's go ahead and put in her hair and then we can put in her features. So let's finish up her hair. Grab that purple, mixed with a little bit of white. I'll give her little bangs that are kind of sweeping down over her forehead a little bit. We'll give her a flower right here in this section. So bring her bangs down just above the halfway mark on her face there. So Grab some white. You doing okay, hon? I hear you yawning over there.
Don't sell me out like that. Come on.
You're not excited about mermaids, I guess, huh?
I'm just your favorite. I'm monitoring the chat for questions.
Got it.
The biggest question right now is if the belly button is an innie or an outie. We got some deep thinkers.
Okay. Well, obviously, I don't know. I guess there would be nobody to tie it off. So, well, maybe her mom would. She's got hands after all. Surely they can get a hold of some scissors. They're not completely without resources. Okay. Good. Now for her face, for her features, you're going to want to remember that her chin's here. So you're going to do like a line straight up from there and then make a T with that. So her eyes are not going to be across from each other this way. Since her face is tilted, they're going to be at an angle to match the tilt of her chin. So if you go from her chin up to the top of her head and then do a T across, that's where her two eyes are going to go. If that makes sense. So.
And you did a face painting a couple months back. So if they want to learn how to draw a face, do a face, there's painting for that.
So. I'll set her side by side there. I'm going to grab a little bit of the black with my liner brush. You could use you could leave her face blank like we did the angel. Honestly, I almost did that, but then I thought I got so much grief over the angel not having a face. I thought I better give her a face. So she got a face. Face makes it a little bit harder. I would say it ups the scale of the difficulty quite a bit. But, you know, just because you've got to be a little bit careful. You could use a Sharpie or something like that, though. You know, don't feel like you have to use a pen or a brush if you're not comfortable with it. So, all right. So the eyes that I did, I just wanted to keep it simple. So I did two kind of semicircles like this. Actually, that's the wrong space placement for those. Oops, now I just covered her face. Let me do that again. Darn it. Did I do that? Okay, we'll try this again. This eye is going to be close to the edge on this side. See how close it is to the side of the face? So it's going to be almost touching the edge of the face, and this one's going to be more in the middle. So I did not do that, which I needed to. Nothing like live. Actually, let's just let that dry because I'm afraid if I mess with it right now, it's going to lift off. Let's put some shadows on her body. We'll come back to the face. Sorry about that. I wasn't paying attention to what I was doing there. All right, so I'm going to grab the...
At least it was on camera this time.
True.
They could see you mess up. Camera. Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, honey. You're so supportive.
Hey, there you go.
I'm going to grab a little bit of phthalo blue just on the tip. So it's loaded with teal, grabbing the phthalo blue on the tip, and then I'm just going to find a clean spot and blend those two together. Grab a little bit more of the teal just on the back end here. Make sure I've got a good blend. Add some water to make it flow. And then I'm going to start up at the top here, and I'm going to keep that edge, right, that dark edge, right along the outside of her body. And just paint. Not putting a whole lot of pressure on it. Let the brush do the work. See, it's going to do that. Oh, there's a shine on that. Sorry. But you can kind of see how dark it is there. I might even add a little tiny bit of purple. Get it nice and dark. There we go.
Somebody asked, But how long did it take you to get comfortable doing faces?
I don't know. I still have to have a good reference photo. I can't, I don't do enough of them. But I took a college course on faces. I mean, I drew faces a lot in high school. I had a weekly project where you had to, you know, turn in something, and 90% of those were faces out of magazines mostly. So, you know, probably that. And then when I did it in college, it definitely reinforced, you know, drawing. We would have to start every show with a drawing of the person, or every show, every class with the drawing of the person sitting to our next to us in class. So I'm just adding the same color underneath her chest. This will make it look rounded. Okay. And then the light's hitting here. It'll hit this part. So I wouldn't want to continue the dark there, but I'm going to continue it on this side. So I don't really know, honestly. That's a good question. I mean, it just takes practice mostly. You know, if you think about, you know, that when I started in school, where, you know, you're doing it daily, or, you know, at least 3 times a week for, you know, a year or two, you know, and I mean, it didn't take that long, you know, before, you know, probably mid-semester or so, you start feeling a little bit comfortable with the whole process, so.
Well, I will say that your boho girl tutorial was very good, because even I did a face.
That's true.
And she looked pretty normal.
Yeah.
So if I can do it, I know everybody out there watching can do it.
That's true.
So now, granted, this will be a much smaller face.
Yeah, it's smaller, and you know, the features are a little bit different because she's looking this direction, and she's not. It's not a straight-on face shot like I was starting to paint when I remembered I was not supposed to. Let's do her tail, and I'm going to use the number 2, I think, for that, and we'll use some glazing medium. Ow. It doesn't want to open. Glazing medium just makes it a little bit more transparent, your colors. So these will be a little bit more see-through-y, which is a technical term. I know you'd like that word, see-through-y. I'm going to use my zinc white as well. So that'll also make it look, zinc white is a transparent color. We'll grab some of this phthalo and mix that with the zinc and the color. We'll grab some of that teal too. Okay. Okay. Let's start at the tip here, and we're just going to pull our lines in. Towards the tip. I'm going to grab a little bit more of that teal, get a little bit more color. There we go. And I'm just going to do kind of stripes that all converge on this one spot. So they'll start at the tip. And narrow at the tail. What you doing?
Answering questions.
Just somebody had asked, what kind of glazing medium are you using?
That one's Liquitex. I'm going to get golden, but because I think the golden one will extend your dry time too a little bit. So this one dries pretty quickly. I'm going to grab a little bit of the purple and mix that up with it. and add some of that in here. You can see it's very see-through-y. It'll dry that way. Let's add some of these ones here. And you might want them a little bit more opaque if you do, just to add a little bit more of your, one of your solid opaque colors like this teal here. Especially like right here where it's attaching, you kind of want a little bit more solid color and then have it fading out into the more see-through sections. Grab some of that see-through color, transparent. All right, we might add a little bit more color to that. I might darken it up a little bit, but I'm gonna let that dry first, and then we'll let's add some of the scales to her dress, or her, not dress, sorry, her tail.
I was gonna say, so this isn't a real mermaid, huh? Just dressed like one.
Add a little bit of that glazing medium to the, I added phthalo blue and teal together. Here, I reserve the right to remain silent. And I'm going to press my brush flat so that it's rounded like a filbert. So the tip is going to be making these little dots. So if you set it down, it's going to make these little rounded shapes. And we want the shapes to, well, if we're going to overlap them, we can, but the rounded part is going to be at the bottom. So we're going to make sure that the brush points down towards the tail, and I'm going to do little dots. And they're not all connected, but just little random dots, kind of in the dark side to start with. So on her shadow section. And you might not even be able to see them very much in these darker areas, and that's okay. This is where, if you got outside your line, you could do your dots right up to the edge to kind of help camouflage that. But always be pointing the tip in the direction that that tail is going. So these ones are going to be kind of facing this direction, and then as you come around, you're going to turn it and be facing straight up with it. Okay, do some of the darker ones over to the lighter side, just a little bit, just a few of them. And then, actually, let's use the white. We'll mix that with that color. Get a little bit lighter color. So this is a lighter blue. And we'll just add a few of the lighter blue. And the highlight section is going to be kind of right here in the middle. There'll go some highlights to the edge here, but this center part will be the brightest section. You really don't have to do a whole lot to indicate these little scales. I'm not doing her entire thing. You could, though. I mean, if you wanted to get really fancy with it, you could definitely, you know, take the time to do her whole thing with scales all the way down perfectly spaced, but I thought this would be a little bit more simple. And you still get the effect of the scales. So we're hoping that John feels better. John Cooney, he's having a bad Crohn's attack. My son has Crohn's, so I can feel for him. It's not good. I hope he feels better tomorrow. And happy birthday to Kim. It's her birthday today. I heard, little birdie told me. She's one of our moderators. I think, right, Kim Sim? Is that, yep. Fun. There's a few more Kim, so I'm making sure I'm saying the right one. You've been awfully quiet today, hon. You're just typing over there.
Yeah, it's about my nap time.
Oh. All right, let's add some to her chest piece here. And then actually this time I'm pulling them down from the top down. I want the scallop part at the top. So... few little dots there. And I thought maybe we could add some shimmer too. So I got some of my interference paints. Thought we could add a little bit of that. This interference green. It'll add some shimmer. This is totally optional though. You don't have to have this part. I'm going to use some white and teal. Do some of that on this side here. Whoops, I'm doing the things in the wrong direction. There we go. And then we'll do a few with the yellow. I went ahead and, oops, didn't mean to get that. Yeah, I went ahead and added some yellow just to kind of give it a different. And I didn't clean out my brush, so it's kind of turning it a little bit green. And just do a few of those in there, just random. Keep them pretty sparse. You don't want to turn her tail green, but kind of helps it make look like it, like the sun's catching it. And then I added a little bit of this color, whoa, to the tail. Grab some of the white with the glazing medium and do a little bit brighter streaks with the white too. There you go. Maybe add a little bit into here. Yellow up here. Keep it at the top edge. Clean that out. I feel like we need a little bit brighter, like a bit really bright. So let's grab some of that white and we'll grab just a tiny bit of the yellow. We'll make kind of a little off-white here, or a little bit of yellow, light yellow. It's only been an hour. That's not bad. Making pretty good time on her. There we go. That's kind of brightening it up a little bit, making it look like my brush doesn't want to go flat. It's too wet. There we go. It's actually okay though. So the smaller ones are a little bit, the brighter ones are a little bit smaller. Let's put a little bit over here on the top of the tail. A little bit on her chest. Just right at the top. Be sure when you're doing these that you don't get any that it look like I don't know. You want a dark one right in the middle or something, because then it's going to look a little bit see-through or something. All right. You know what I'm saying? Just watch that. All right. Grabbing the interference paints now, and I'm just going to add some dots with the interference paints. These are going to go on transparent. You'll be able to see them in the light, though. So I'm just going to dot, dot, dot. Go ahead and do some into the dark areas, too. You can kind of see where they're... If you hold it up to light, you can kind of see where they're going. I'll go ahead and add a little bit to her streaky fins. There's all kinds of different colors of interference paints. This one is a green blue, but you could even use an iridescent.
Okay, I'm going to ask a question.
What?
What does it mean by green blue?
Because
it's clear, isn't it? Or white?
No, but when it shines in the light, it'll look green blue. It'll look turquoise. The shine is a color.
Oh, okay.
So the there's, you know, different colors of them. There's gold and purple and blue and green, red, you know, all kinds of different interference colors. And when they interference ones actually change color when you change the tilt. Some of them will like look red on one side and green on the other, you know, like when you turn them like this. It's kind of like my fingernails. They do that thing where, you know, they look different. Sometimes they look pink and then on the other side they look green. That's what interference paints do. They're as opposed to iridescents, which are just shiny colors. That makes sense.
Sounds magical.
It is magical. That's why we're putting them on her, so she has some magic shine. We could put some in her hair, too, if we wanted. I don't have any of my purple out right now, though. But okay, so let's do her face, and hopefully we won't mess it up this time. Grab my... brush here, a little bit of black. Make sure you water it down, or when you're using a liner brush, it will not work for you if it's too thick. Got to water it down a little bit. Okay, so start this over again. Right about halfway, and we're going to do it in an angle. But this one is going to be right up against this side of the face, and then this one is going to be kind of more right in the middle. There we go. Better. Then grab a little bit extra on the tip of my brush, or you can use a dotting tool, a stylus here, and make a dot if you want to with that. But I'm just going to use my brush and do two. We're only going to do the bottom. We're not going to completely close in the eye. Zoom in really good on it. Whoop. All right, then the nose is going to thin that out. Add some of the unbleached titanium so it's a little bit lighter. It's got a little bit of burnt umber and or burnt sienna and black in there. And I'm going to use it to do the side of the nose, which here's the middle of the nose here. So I'm just going to do a little bit of a shadow along this dark side of the nose, kind of coming down from the tip of the eye. And then a couple of little dots for the nose. It'll look really weird, but it'll Make sure you get them in the right place, though. Oh, now she looks like a pig nose. Okay, try this again. I didn't have any trouble with this when I was doing it on my own, but now I'm thinking about it too much. Okay, there we go. Two little dots for the nose, then very, very small, and then kind of a wiggly line for the mouth. It's going to kind of come up, back down. I think part of the problem is I didn't use this liner brush when I did it. I'm going to switch back over to my spotter. The liner brush is just too floppy. It's not letting me draw with it. Okay, bottom lip. Upper lip is just kind of a wiggly line. It's a little bit darker along the outside edges, and then there we go. Whew, that was harder than I thought it was going to be. Right.
Somebody asked that they
It's a little too low. What? Go ahead.
That they have the iridescent medium.
Uh-huh.
And would that work for the mermaid tail?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Just add it to your teal or whatever color. You might even use it with like a transparent color even. I'm going to fix a little bit of right there. Put a little bit of white highlight. Pick up a little bit of white and use it on her cheeks right here and here. Over here, a little bit on her nose, wipe off my brush, and blend the edges out a little bit, just slightly. Until it starts to blend out. Make sure you catch it while it's wet so that it blends. Get too much, you can always go back in and add a little bit more of your unbleached titanium and just kind of blend around the edges a little bit with it.
And did you add white around the eyes or was
no,
that?
I just
no,
left
just
it.
Put the black.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yep. I'm going to round out her forehead on this side a little bit. Her hair kind of covered up her forehead. Some right there. Clean up the outside edge of her cheek. Slightly. Give her a little highlight on her chin. And this is where you can kind of clean up the nose too if you get it too low or, you know, in a weird place. But I think that that looks okay. Her nose is a little bit long, but I think it's all right. And I just went ahead and left the center of it open. You know, I didn't do anything special with it. So you can make her lips red if you want, or whatever you want to do. Add a little bit of white highlights to the eyes. And that's all I did with her face. Okay. Then to finish her outfit there, I put a little bit of a dark blue teal kind of thing that goes across there to anchor it, and just a few little darker shadows up underneath. You could give her a necklace if you wanted. We can. Oh, I did have a little bit of a tiny bit of a shadow. With that under here where kind of right where her shoulders, across from her shoulders, there's like a little dip there where her collarbone starts. Just like a little hollow in her, the base of her throat right there. Not that dark, but you get the idea. There we go. All right. Her hair should be dry now, so I'm just going to use a damp cloth And go through here and just wipe off underneath all this chalk or pencil lines from the Scryball. And it's water soluble, so that it'll wipe off clean when I do this. And it should come off from around the mermaid too. You might want to give it a day, but... Huh? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll do that. I need to add some fish around her, too. There we go. Okay, so... Use... I'm trying to think what brush I would be best for that. I think I'm going to use this brush. So long flat. We'll use the glazing medium. We'll grab a little bit of the transparent white. And we might add just a tiny bit of the phthalo blue to it so it's not straight white white. Because this is just a teeny, teeny, tiny bit of blue is all you'll need. I want it nice and transparent. We'll start at the point where you want the light rays to show and just sort of flick your brush down with this transparent color. We can add a little bit more of the bright white. The zinc white here straight. It's not showing up enough. You can always go brighter. I just like to start out kind of conservative and work my way to the darker, brighter colors. There we go. I don't know if you can see that on the camera. I'll tilt it. Just keeping on adding that paint. I can turn my brush to the edge so that I get some lines, more straight lines. The idea is that it's streaked and it's see-through. So even where it's thicker, you should still be able to kind of have that transparency to it. That makes sense. I don't know if that's good enough. Good. Okay. You can always go brighter with it, but I think for now I'm going to just leave that. And I want to add some fish. And really, ideally, I would have done that when I did my background. You could do some extra streaks, but... When I did this background, I would have added a little bit brighter over in this corner and done it a little bit differently. Because I have my light streaks over here, so my highlights over here on the water. So, but I think it's still okay. Grab some white and just a little bit of blue. Make a light blue. I'll use a teal. And we're going to make some fish that are coming around the side and overlapping her dress just a little bit. They're sort of spear-shaped, so think of a spear tip. There's a little bit of a tail at the back, but not really much. That. We'll do a couple coming up this way. And this is just white with a little bit of blue in it. Add one kind of coming peeking out from behind her. Do a couple that are coming in front of her hair.
Now, are those fish that like follow around sharks and just clean them all day long?
I don't think these ones are.
Okay.
They could have been, I guess, but...
They're just something she threw on to go out?
Right. Okay. Yeah, they're just accessory fish.
Accessory fish.
Right. And we'll add some little dark stripes to them. We'll give some black. And I'm just going to add little stripes along them. Got a little bit of that white mixed in, so it's not solid black. Doing four lines. They're a little bit curved, too, since your fish body is curved. Makes a little bit of sense. Just give them some eyes. Grab my... Let's do these ones with some blue. Actually, let's use ultramarine blue here with some white. We'll do some stripes on these guys this way. And then some black eyes. Toward the top. We can do some color on them if we want. I might do some little pink on these guys. I'll do a pink stripe in the body. I did want to go back and highlight this guy right here, because I felt like he was kind of disappearing against this shelf, so I'm going to add some brighter color around him to make him pop out of that reef a little bit more. There we go. And then I'm going to use this liner brush and some of this pink with white. This is quinacridone magenta. And I'm going to go over the top of some of these and make them more like those wiggly corals that have all of those brain ones that kind of have those weird shapes. I felt like I wanted to have at least one or two of those kind over here. I forgot to do that the other night. We kind of ran out of time. And then you can add details or do another one over here that's just kind of by itself. Add a little bit of the quinacridone magenta in the middle. All right. Do we need to add any more fish? Are we good? Are we about done? What do you think?
Looks good to me.
Good to you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like that. Oh, let's do some seaweed right here. That's what I was going to do. Let's grab that green and
yeah, add that's some white to it. That's what I was thinking. Some seaweed right there. Or like an old anchor or something or shipwreck. Is she one of those that sings to the sailors going by and cause them to wreck their ships?
Oh, no. Sink? She might be.
She kind of has that look.
She could be.
Mm-hmm.
They have been known to do mischief. So let's do some long. Add a little bit more white to that so I can see it. I added a little. This is mostly phthalo green. I added a little bit of phthalo blue just so that it's not completely green. We'll add some seaweed. The leaves. Or like, I don't even know if that's seaweed. It's more like a plant. Let's add some yellow highlights to it. We're pretty much done. If you want to, I mean, I'm just playing now, so if they have any suggestions for things they'd like to see, we can add some more stuff. But
oh, they've said squid, manta ray.
Manta ray.
Ooh. Put flowers in her hair. I guess
oh, yeah, the flower.
Like
thank you.
Like a boho.
I forgot the flower. Well, I was supposed to do that already.
Really? Where would she get a flower from?
And it's like one of these. She plucked one of these out of the thing.
Oh, okay.
She's wearing it in her hair.
So she stuck something living in her hair like that.
Right.
Okay. I guess that's what flowers are here anyways.
Yeah. What do you have against mermaids? I just hear a lot of negativity in your voice right here.
Well, nothing. Nothing at all. No.
Yeah. Got a lot of skepticism about this whole thing today. right here. Just do little brush strokes in towards the center. I've got yellow. I mixed a little bit of white with it. This is the cadmium yellow light. There we go. And then we'll add a little bit of the phthalo blue to it. It'll kind of mix with the color, and we'll do the center with that color. I need more white. Got a white water dot on it. Every time I clean out my brush, I never wipe it down. I almost forget to get the water drops right on my thing. All right, there we go. Yeah, I feel like her hair, now that I'm looking at this, I feel like her hair could be a little bit farther in right here. There we go. Add a little bit more highlight to her bangs. Now that we've got our eyes in, we can kind of fix that. My paints are getting sticky. They're drying. Let me, whoop, not quite. Oh, great. Okay, I need to stop because I'm just fiddling with it now.
Yeah, I need to start thinking about what you're going to put on Stickman.
Oh, Stickman, I forgot mm-hmm. about him.
What? That's the whole reason why we do the show. I mean, that's why you have close to 140 people watching right now.
Right.
Is because of they want to say,
waiting for Stickman.
Yeah, mermaid, whatever, fish, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Stickman, come on.
All right. Need a little bit more white here. I'm going to use this white with the purple in it and add a little bit along this side of her body here on these little things, a little bit in her tail too. I had some purple in the example. That'll just pull that purple down into her body a little bit. We don't need a lot, but it'll help unify her and give her a little bit of just a few little purple dots in her body too. Use that brighter white and add a little bit of highlight to her fishes. Just to pop them out a little bit more. I know you're waiting on the stick man. Sorry, I'm just I'm having fun with her, so just gonna have to wait. Mark Anderson.
Oh, we're just in a discussion and people are suggesting a seashell bra for Stickman. And I'm claiming that it'll clash with his heels.
I kind of think I like the bra idea.
And where is it going to go?
We could give him... Well, we could put a fish on the end of his line, I guess. But that's kind of mean. A seashell bra. He could have a tail. I mean, he's got antlers. Why not?
Hey, it can be whatever we want it to be.
Stickman's our mascot. If Mark drew him and I add something to him every week that pertains to whatever we're painting that day.
Mm-hmm. I'm
afraid to leave do a tail. I think he needs the bra. He's getting a bra. Well, it's a little high, actually. Now that I think about it, it's probably under his arms, but that's all right. This doesn't look like anything, does it? Because there's nothing for it to attach to.
Hey, like you said, he has antlers, so I'm wearing stiletto red heels.
He's a cross-dresser.
With a cup of coffee.
Maybe he's a girl. I'm just saying.
No.
Maybe
no,
we
no,
got
no,
this
no.
wrong, and
he's just
a girl.
He's just a secure stick. That's all.
He's got no problems with his gender identity. Oh, that looks so weird. I don't know.
That's okay.
That's okay.
We can move on now.
We can move on.
We can go back to the regularly scheduled program.
Okay. That Yeah, I don't know about that.
Disturbing.
Just, it's very disturbing.
That'll be in people's nightmares tonight.
All right, I think she's good. You know, you could always keep adding different things. I had thought about doing a like a dolphin or something like that, but I don't know if we have room for it really. So
yeah, but people can add whatever fish they want to their paintings and post them in the Thankful Art group on Facebook. Love to see that.
Exactly. Mm. Yes. Thank you guys so much for watching today. I hope you check out Cinnamon's video tomorrow. She'll be doing her mermaid, Mermaid Cove, it's called. And whoops, there's the whole thing and all her glory. The sun's shining down on her. Hope you've enjoyed it today. Thank you guys who stopped by to watch. We really appreciate you. And we will see you on Tuesday. We'll be doing a succulent. Please like, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And we will see you next time. Thanks, guys. Bye.